Hi there. Have you ever wondered what the difference between short run and long run supply are? How they're different? How they're the same? Well, let's get into it. So one of the key things that we need to remember is that there is no time definition when it comes to the difference between when a short run becomes a long run or a long run is a short run. It would help. A lot, tremendously, I know. All right, well, let's take a look at some of the key differences and features of both. One of the key features when it comes to short run is that you have sunk costs or fixed costs. They are already paid and committed to, such as your factory location, your machines, or perhaps your office and your lease. Something that you cannot escape from. It's always going to be there. Whereas in long run, we don't have that calculated in there. There is no fixed or sunk cost because it's kind of like you haven't committed yet. Think of long run more like that friend who's still flirting but not quite in a relationship yet. They haven't quite committed to it. When it comes back to short run, an organization or a firm cannot exit but can shut down. So they cannot exit the market that they're in because they're committed to it. And they can shut down though, if they end up making a profit that is below a certain minimum value that they are willing to accept. On the other hand, organizations and firms in the long run can enter and exit a market at will, depending on the value of profit or total revenue. Now, the number of organizations and firms in a market are fixed in the short run, and also a short run situation will produce if price is greater than or equal to the average variable cost. And profits over here can be positive, negative, or zero. Over here we have that the long run situation can still choose the scale of production, such as what size of factory that they want to lease, purchase, or build. And organizations or firms will enter the market if price is greater than the average total cost, and exit if price is less than the average total cost. And equilibrium is reached if price equals the average total cost, or essentially profit revenue being zero. So let's go down here for a moment and take a look at some of the math and some of the things that are associated with this. When it comes to total revenue can always be expressed as price times by quantity. And profit equals total revenue minus total costs. And if this is zero, so for example, our equilibrium, then we end up with a negative total fixed cost. And again, the company will produce, or the firm organization will produce, if price times by quantity minus total fixed cost minus the average variable cost times by quantity is greater than or equal to negative total fixed costs. And if total fixed cost is zero, we can simplify it further to say that price has to be greater than or equal to the average variable cost. I hope that helped you out. If you need anything for graphs or for measuring that sort of information to compare the two and how they interlock, let me know in the comments below and I'll get right on that. Until then, thank you very much for your time. If you found this useful or helpful, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit that bell for notifications. Look forward to seeing you next time. Bye!